भ्यो नम हरि ओं गणान्वा गणपतिगुं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तम ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पत आनश्वन्वन्नोतिभिस्सेद सादनम् श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां। यू मे से दिस श्लोकम् शारदा शारदाम्भोज वदना वदनाम्बुजे सर्वदा सर्वदास्माकं सन्निधिः सन्निधिं क्रियात। इसे वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग श्लोकम मीनिंग आई विल टेल ऑन सम अदर टाइम। वन मोर श्लोकम वंशी विभूषित करात नवनीरदाभात पीतांबरात अरुणबिंब फलाधरोष्ठात पूर्णेन्दु सुंदर मुखात अरविंद नेत्रात कृष्णात्परम किमपि तत्वमहं न जाने। इट इज ए डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ लॉर्ड श्री कृष्ण। आई विल टेल द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस ऑल्सो सम अदर टाइम। Somebody asked me for this shloka, that's why I told you to recite. So, nachashta krucharam krupano jamayaya, up to that we have come. This elephant, like even a human being, was very arrogant, was very indulgent, busy in enjoying the carnal pleasures, busy with the social life and the picnic-like enjoyment with family members and all that. So a big social life. People have a very big social life. They are committed to social life. You visit our house this Sunday. Next Sunday, we will visit your house. So both Sundays are gone. So you will not be able to do anything meaningful on both Sundays. And they talk for hours, just all blabbering. There will be no substance in the talk. So one should not waste time like that. So because we waste our time and energy, it is all dissipated in that way. Suddenly a calamity comes and we will be helpless to handle it. So one should not be like that. So that is the purpose of this story. We will do the next shlokam. Tatha turam yothapatim karenavah vikrushyamanam tarasa baliyasa. I think one shlokam I skipped, yeah. We will do the earlier one. Tam tatra kaschit nrupa daiva choditaha graho baliyan charane rushagrahit. You see the sandhi, baliyan charane. If you club, it becomes baliyansh charane. तथा यदृच्छयैवं व्यसनं गतो गजः यथा बलं सोति बलो विचक्रमे। नृप नृप मीन्स ओ किंग Shuka Maharshi is addressing the king. He is already addressing. Why he should say suddenly Nrupa? There is a reason. The story is now taking a very important turn. So suppose Nrupa, the king, was just dozing off or his mind is elsewhere. Chalta, because the description part, suppose you hear the description of the forest and then skip the description of the elephants and the animals of the forest, you don't lose much. So, as far as the story is concerned, everything is okay. The description can be skipped. People generally skip the description because you need a particular disposition to enjoy the description. So anyway, this point you cannot skip. If you skip this shlokam, then there is no story at all. That's why a very important turn in the story. That's why Henrupa is exhorting the king. O king, now what happened, you know, so like that. Tam means that elephant. Tatra means in that pool, in that lake. Tam, that elephant, it's a second case. Kaschit grahaha agrahit. Ready the vakya. Kaschit, one. Grahaha means an alligator. Agrahit, it caught. Catching. Grahanam is catching. So agrahit is an interesting usage. It's past. Yesterday I was telling you lung for past. This is lung, agrahit. Jagraha lit, agrunhat lung, agrahit lung. Interesting usage. So agrahit means it caught. An alligator caught this elephant in that lake. Baliyan. It's a very strong alligator. I tell you, alligators, they are very, very strong. Recently I have seen in newspaper, one news item. So one particular alligator in a zoo caught a big animal. By mistake, that animal strayed into this lake and the alligator caught it. And now the zoo authorities were helpless. The animal was killed. That came in newspaper just 2 days back. Anyway, so this alligator, its jaws are very powerful, very protruding jaws they will be there, and very powerful. So it is as though 2 big blocks of iron come shut together suddenly, and nothing can escape from between them. And the teeth of the alligator are as sharp as knives. So as if 2 doors having knives, they come close, they are shut together. And the leg of this elephant was held in between. No way of escaping. So Baliyan, Charane Rusha Agrahit. It was very angry because its territory was invaded by this elephant. That is the anger. So this is a territorial thing it is. So the animal doesn't accept its territory to be transgressed by any other animal. So Rasha Agrahit, with all its anger it has shown and it has caught the leg of that elephant. Yadruchayaivam Yasanam Gato Gajaha, Gajaha, the elephant. Evam Yasanam Gataha. Yasanam is a calamity. So it got into a calamity in this fashion. Yadruchaya. Yadruchaya means without any apparent reason. It just happened accidentally. Yadruchaya. So, but in Gita this word comes from Yadruchha. Yadruchalabha santushtaha. It is there in Gita. There Bhashyakara says Yadruchha is not just something which came to him unexpectedly. That is not the meaning. Yadruchha means Ishwarechha ityartha. So Ishwarechhaya, nothing happens on its own. Suppose an ant pricks you, that also happens only after Bhagavan's permission is taken. That is what we say. So nothing happens without Ishwara's approval. Hence, Yadruchhaya means Ishwarechhaya ityartha. When you cannot recognize Ishwara in it, it becomes accidental. If you recognize Ishwara in it, it becomes Ishwarechha. So సో ఎదురుచ్ఛయా ఇది ఈశ్వర ఇచ్ఛ. యా దైవచోదిత గ్రాహ, యా యు ఆర్ రైట్. సో దట్ ఈజ్ ఆల్ ది మోర్ రీజన్ టు సే ఎదురుచ్ఛయా మీన్స్ ఈశ్వర ఇచ్ఛయ. సో జనరల్లీ వేదాంతిన్స్ వెన్ ఎవర్ ద సీ ఎదురుచ్ఛా దే టేక్ ఇట్ యాజ్ ఈశ్వర ఇచ్ఛ, బికాస్ ఇన్ గీత ఇట్ ఈస్ టేకన్ లైక్ దట్. సో దైవచోదిత, యాజ్ హీ హాజ్ వెరీ కరెక్ట్లీ పాయింటెడ్ అవుట్, సో ఇన్స్పైర్డ్ బై దైవం ఈజ్ కర్మఫలం. పరమేశ్వర ఈజ్ ఇన్ ది ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ ప్రారబ్ధ కర్మ. ప్రారబ్ధ ఈశ్వర సార్థర్ మీన్స్ ఈజ్ ఇన్ ది ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ ప్రారబ్ధ కర్మ ఫర్ ఎవ్రీ జీవ. సో దైవచోదిత మీన్స్ దట్ ఈశ్వర చోదిత అథవా కర్మనీయతి చోదిత అథవా ప్రారబ్ధ చోదిత అటవర్ ఇన్స్పైర్డ్ బై దట్ ఈజ్ గ్రాహ హస్ కాట్. అండ్ ఇన్ దిస్ వే బై ద విష్ ఆఫ్ ఈశ్వర దిస్ ఎలిఫెంట్ హ్యాస్ నౌ ఎ వెరీ సీరియస్ ప్రాబ్లమ్ ఆన్ ఇట్స్ హ్యాండ్స్. బట్ దెన్ అతిబల సహ దట్ ఎలిఫెంట్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో హ్యావింగ్ అ లాట్ ఆఫ్ స్ట్రెంగ్త్. ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ దట్ ది ఎలిగేటర్ ఎలోన్ ఈజ్ బలీయాన్, ఈవెన్ ది ఎలిఫెంట్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో బలీయాన్ అతిబల. సో విత్ ఇన్ ది లిమిట్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇట్స్ స్ట్రెంగ్త్ యథాబలం సహా విచక్రమే. విచక్రమే మీన్స్ స్ట్రగుల్డ్, ఇట్ స్టార్టెడ్ స్ట్రగ్లింగ్ అండ్ ఫైటింగ్ ఇట్ అవుట్ టు ది ఎక్స్టెంట్ ఇట్ కెన్ విత్ ఇన్ ది లిమిట్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇట్స్ బలం. యథాబలం మీన్స్ బలం అనతిక్రమ్య. సో విత్ ఇన్ ఇట్స్ ఓన్ స్ట్రెంగ్త్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఫైటింగ్. వెరీ సింపుల్ శ్లోకం. సో దిస్ ఆర్తభక్త when we land in some trouble, we try to wriggle out of it, and when we fail to do that and the situation becomes utterly helpless, then only we remember Ishvara. That is a natural way this person behaves. Anyway, next shloka. Vichukrushuhu dina dhiyopare gajaha పార్ష్ణిగ్రహాః తారయితుం నచాశకన్. సో ఎర్లియర్ పాదం ఇస్ ఆల్సో దేర్, ఐ మిస్ ఇట్. సో తథాతురం యూథపతిం కరేణవః వికృష్యమానం తరసా బలీయసా విచుక్రుషుర్దీన ధియోపరే గజాః పార్ష్ణిగ్రహాస్తారయుతుం నచాశకన్. తథా ఆతురం, తథా మీన్స్ ఇందక్తే, ఆతురం ఫౌండ్ హిమ్సెల్ఫ్ ఇన్ డిఫికల్టీ. సో ఆతురం యూథపతిం, హీ ఈజ్ ది లీడర్ ఆఫ్ ది హెర్డ్. When the leader is in trouble, all the followers try to save the leader from the trouble naturally. Therefore, Aturam found in trouble, Yothapatim, that leader. So, Karenavaha, all these other elephants. Tarasa Baliyasa Vikrushyamanam. Baliyasa Grahena means very strong alligator. By the very strong alligator, Tarasa means very fast. Vikrushyamanam, being dragged inside into the lake. So this is the fate of that elephant. So then the other elephants, Karenavaha, these male and female elephants of the herd, what they did? Vichukrushuhu. Apare gajaha vichukrushuhu. So means they were shrieking with alarm, with alarm. Shrieking. They are making a big noise of pain. Ayo, ayo, like that they were making noise. So when somebody is in trouble, the entire household erupts into a big shrieking noise. So vichukrushuhu dena dhiyaha. So what happens is, when everything is cozy and comfortable, that dainyam doesn't come into the picture. Dainyam, we don't know what is dainyam. Dainyam means helplessness. When everything is cozy, the dainyam we don't know. Suddenly something goes wrong, the person becomes dina, helpless. In fact, this dainyam, the discovery of helplessness, is considered one very fundamental qualification for bhakti. It is described like that. Shankara also, in a few places where he described bhakti, he describes it in terms of discovering helplessness. In Saundarya Hari he says, Daviyamsam Dinam Snapaya Krupaya Mamapi Shive, like that he says. He Shive means He Lalita. Daviyamsam, I remained very far from you, at a very long distance from you. So I am separated, estranged from you. Daviyamsam. Hence Dinam. Therefore, helpless. So being estranged, I am helpless. Therefore now you take me near you, like even the mother takes the child near to its near. Similarly, you take me near you and help me come out of this dainyam. So snapaya krupaya mamapi shive. So you shower your grace upon me. Like that he implores the mother. So in the bhakti shastram, this discovery of the helplessness of an individual is considered a very fundamental qualification for imploring. That is bhakti, that is artha bhakti. Artha means one who is in serious trouble, he is imploring the Bhagavan. That is the artha bhakti. So we have the word arthanadam. So the person makes a loud noise out of utter helplessness. So that is how Parameshwara is to be implored. All these animals, Parshti Grahaha. Parshti means the hind portion of this elephant which is being dragged inside the lake. So they try to help the elephant out of that lake by dragging the elephant in the opposite direction, by holding on to their hind legs. So with their trunks, they hold on to the hind legs and try to push the elephant out of that lake. Suppose they succeed, then the alligator tries to pull it inside, whereas these elephants, they try to pull this herd leader outside. Suppose they succeed, then the alligator will release its hold and it will go inside, because it won't venture outside. It will be in danger, so it will go. So the accident, the danger is averted. It is possible. So that's why Parshni Grahaha Tarayutum Nachashakan. They tried it, but they could not help this elephant to come out of that catastrophe, to come out of that adversity. Therefore, when their efforts to help this elephant have failed, then what else they can do? Apare Vijaha Dhyanadhyaha. So their helplessness, their mind was filled with helplessness. So vichukrushu, they were shrieking with pain and with dukkham, affliction. So that is the shloka. Next, niyudhyato revam ibhendra natrayoho vikarshatoho antarato bahirmithaha समासहस्रम् व्यगमन् महीपते सप्राणयोः चित्रममं सतामराः एवं नियुध्यतोः. यू नो नियुद्ध इज सम सॉर्ट ऑफ ए जूडो. इट इज ए टेक्निकल नेम. Yuddha means that one of the martial arts. So an Indian name, a Sanskrit name for one of the martial arts is called Niyuddha. So in Ramayanam, this Niyuddha is described. Sugriva and Vali, they fight with each other. So Valmiki Maharshi describes the Niyuddha. So, and I know at least a few schools of martial arts where Niyuddha is taught. Anyway, Niyuddhyatoho. So they were fighting two animals are fighting. One is an alligator and the other is an elephant. So nitaram yudhyatoh, you can say. With all their ability they are fighting. Evam. Who are they? Ibhendra nakrayoh. Ibhendra, Ibha is elephant. Ibhendra means a strong elephant. the leader of the elephants. So Ibhendra. Nakra is an alligator. And so you have the Dvandva Samasam. Ibhendrascha Nakrascha. Ibhendra Nakrau. So convert it into Shashti Asaptami Dvivachanam. Tayoho. Ibhendra Nakrayoho. So this elephant and alligator, while they were fighting, Niyodhishatoho. This usage is called Sati Saptami. You must have heard this usage. Rame Gacchati. This sentence follows further. Rame, Saptameya Kavachanam, Gacchati. That is also Saptameya Kavachanam. Gacchan is the noun. So Gacchati. Rame Gacchati Sati. While Rama is going, that is the meaning. So it represents a time in which that action is taking place. That kind of usage is called Sati Saptami. So here also same. So, Ibhendra Nakrayoho Evam Niyudhyatoho. While the alligator and the elephant are fighting in this fashion, how they are fighting? Vikarshatoho. They are pulling, each pulling in its own direction. How? Mithaha Vikarshatoho. So the elephant pulls the alligator, and the alligator pulls the elephant. Bahir antarato bahihi. Antarataha, the alligator pulls inside the lake. The more it gains 1 inch inside, that is an advantage for it. And the elephant can be saved, can save itself only by pulling outside the lake. Any space it can gain by pulling outside the lake, a few inches also it can gain, that's a big gain. So it can win finally. So like this, mithaha vikarshatoho, one inside the lake, antarataha bahihi, the other outside the lake. So like that they were fighting. Sahasram samaha vyagaman, mahipate. So mahipate means he is again addressing the king with that astonishment. O king, like that while they were fighting, 1,000 years have gone. Sahasram samaha vyagaman. 1,000 years time has gone. So, a romanticism in this story. So, a long time has gone. This story purpose we know, it has got this allegory, so that imagery is there. So, the person, he is very arrogant, yesterday I was telling it. Now, he was struck with a disease, suppose. A disease. A heart attack or some such disease. And he is joined in the hospital. So he will be struggling with all his money power and all that still to win over that disease. So he has got a power, money is there and other things are there. So if a rich man becomes ill, so he becomes a VIP patient. So there will be lots of advantages for him. In the hospital he can have a TV also. So in his room, the room can be air conditioned. All the facilities can be there. But the disease doesn't know all this. The disease, it doesn't distinguish between a rich VIP patient and a normal patient. It doesn't distinguish. It has got its own course. So it will be advancing in its own path. Anyway, this is how we have to understand the imagery. So we don't want to give up. We want to fight it out. Bhagavan, we will see Bhagavan. Bhagavan is the last resort. So we will think of it later, that as an alternative, the concept itself doesn't enter the mind. Bhagavan we will see later. Now he is not in the picture at all. So still that arrogance and that power, I can achieve anything with my ability. This kind of ahankara, that very inflated ego, it is still working. So samas sahasram yagaman. Still both are alive. That is a great thing. Sapranayoho. They are still alive. Neither the elephant gave up, nor the alligator. Sapranayoho. So, in the meanwhile, these devatas, they came to know about it. Because that lake is a frequent spot, frequently visited by these apsarasas. So they came and saw that the lake is no more useful for swimming and all that. So they went back and reported, so the news spread in the Devaloka also. So they observed that the fight is going on so long, 1,000 years the fight went. It's a romanticism, nothing more than that. So chitram amam sata, amaraha chitram amam sata. So those of you who are studying dhatupatha, this is an occasion to verify your capacity in dhatus. Amam sata is an atmanepadi lung, manyate, that is the dhatu. So atmanepadi lung, very difficult prayoga. Anyway, amaraha amam sata chitram. This is indeed a big wonder it is. So neither the elephant nor the alligator is yet dead. They are still fighting. That is something very amazing. Hemahipate. Then next slokam. Tato gajendrasya mano balau jasam kalena dirghena महानभूद्व्ययः विकृष्यमानस्य जलेव सीदतः विपर्ययोभूत् सकलं जलौकसः ततः मीन्स् देन् गजेन्द्रस्य फर् दिस् एलिफेण्ट् किङ्ग् व्ययः महान् अभूत् देर् वाज् ए लाट् आफ् डिप्लीशन् व्ययः मीन्स् एक्स्पेण्डिचर् वेन् इट् इस् मनी बट् इन् दिस् कण्टेक्स्ट् इट् इस् डिप्लीशन् मीन्स् दि इट् इस् स्लोली अण्ड् स्टेडली कमिङ्ग् डौन् वाट् मनोबलौजसाम् मनः द मोरेल् बला इस् द स्ट्रेङ्थ् आफ् दि बाडी ओजस् इस् द वैटालिटि आफ् दि बाडी. So ojas is, the strength is the physical strength which is readily available for expression in the form of a fighting ability or whatever. So when some reserves will be there, this strength is not enough, some extra reserves will be there in the body. So those extra reserves will manifest in a very dire situation. So that vitality of the body to give one last ditch fight, that is called ojas. Probably you can look at it like that. Or in general, a vitality of the body. So the body can rise to the occasion and put forward extra energy and try to win the situation. So that is ojas. So morale, strength and vitality, all the three were gradually depleted for the elephant. Because it is in the enemy territory, whereas the alligator is its own territory. That is the advantage of place is there for the alligator. So in water, elephant is, it is not its normal territory, so it is not comfortable in water. Whereas for the alligator, water is its very nice place, very cozy place for it. So gajendrasya manobalau jasam vyayaha mahan abhut. In a big way, these things are depleted, especially because the fight was going on for a long time. Dirghena kalena mahan vyayaha abhut. How this elephant, what is its condition? Vikrushyamanasya jale avasidataha. So it is losing ground gradually. It is losing ground. Vikrushyamanasya, it is dragged further and further into the pool. So as the depth is increasing and it is further dragged inside the pool, jale avasidataha, it is not able to get that hold in the water. So now the situation is slipping out of its hands or out of its control. Avasidataha means it is slowly getting destroyed, languishing, it is getting consumed, languishing in the water. So jale avasidataha. This is the position of that elephant. Now, what about the alligator? Jalaukasaha. For the alligator, jalaukaha means jale okaha yasyasaha. Jale in water. Okaha living place. Okaha means living place. Yasyasaha. So jalaukaha. Tasya jalaukasaha. Vedhashabdavatu. So jalaukasaha, for that alligator, sakalam viparyayaha abhut. Everything was just the opposite. Means what? Manobalau jasam mahan vruddhihi abhut. Instead of depletion, the morale is increasing, strength is increasing because it is going further inside the deeper water. And also its vitality is also increasing, its morale is increasing, everything is increasing. And it is gaining ground. While the elephant is losing ground, it is gaining ground and it is now slowly gaining upper hand. So it is it started enjoying the fight because slowly things are coming into its hand. So this is how the situation is slowly slipping out of the hands of the elephant. You see, this Bhagavatam is translated into various languages and it is very popular throughout the country. Because the stories of Bhagavata, there are very large number of stories are there. Each story is a very beautiful story. So, especially in Telugu language, there is a great poet called Bommera Potanna. So, he translated in Telugu. And the Telugu poems are very popular. So, I will just read a poem from Telugu. Those of you who do not know Telugu, please bear with me. Just one poem only. I will not bother you with many. So, this fight is described in one poem. Very interesting poem. Uha galangi jivanapu tolamunambadi porutun maha mohalatanibaddha padamun vidipinchukonangaleka sandehamu bundu dehi kriya dinadashan gijamunde भीषण ग्राह दुरंत दंत परिघटित पाद खुराग्र शल्यमयी. दिस इज हाउ Bommera Potanna हैज डिस्क्राइब्ड इट. सो दोज ऑफ यू हू नो तेलुगु माइट क्लियरली अंडरस्टैंड इट. देर आर वन आर टू वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग समासास. सो इट इज कॉल्ड तेलुगु एक्सेप्ट दोज प्रत्ययास डूमु ऊलु एक्सेट्रा. इट इज एंटायरली सांस्क्रिट ओनली. सो महामोहलता निबद्ध पदमुन विडिपिंचुकोनंगलेक దేన దేహిక్రియ. సో ది ఎలగరీ ఇస్ వెరీ క్లియర్.